Todd's a little frustrated because his team not contending. He's been there, done that his years with the Phillies, a 34-year-old lefty. Is he a guy you think at the trade deadline somebody can make a move for, a club option after this year for $20 million?
It's a lot of money, but I believe he can help any rotation, be a veteran guy, especially if you match him up in the middle of that rotation, be the second or third slot guy.
Right. He had a not the ace.
Not the ace, but he can be help. He'd be a nice little side dish. He'd be a nice little crab dish for that. But again, 2.70 ERA coming into this ballgame over the last seven starts. He had a little hiccup towards the end. I love the way he commands the strike zone. He's not afraid to miss bats. Like you said, he thinks about the game mentally, right, and he still has the command and the velocity to beat a lot of teams.
Yeah, man, I faced this guy in the World Series back in 09. I know that feels like ages ago. But this is a guy that wants to be in that spotlight, man. Right. He wants to pitch for a contender.
He thrives in that.
You're right. He wants to be there. He's not that type of guy that's going to overpower you. You know, I mean, you saw Gerrit Cole tonight, who was absolutely electric, running it up to 99 miles an hour. He's got a little sink. He's got a little cut. He's got a good changeup. But when you're throwing that and you don't have that electric stuff, you can't be missing in the big part of the plate, man. I hope he gets an opportunity to play for a contender because I'd like to see him pitch sometime late in September.
Yeah, but
even in this type of game, though, he was able to go deep into
it. Gave you the innings. Yeah. You have a team in mind that you think he could.
Yeah, you know what? I mean, just from all the grumblings that have been going around and
the truth.
From the people that I've talked to, I heard Philly could be a destination. Cole could be going back home. Obviously, that's kind of up in the air right
now.
But I'm just saying, man, from my sources, that's what I've heard.
Yeah, he has sources.
I got sources now.
That's big. It's interesting. His home ERA is almost two runs higher than his road ERA.
Arlington's a very tough place to play. You love hitting
there. Oh, everybody
loves
it.
So the numbers can be a little obscured over there, but he definitely focuses on the road. And this is a tough situation. The West has gotten better. Everyone's gotten better except the Rangers. So I think he feels that his time is up any day now. So that's tough to go out there and focus and pitch.
Also, as a pitcher, man, when you're getting absolutely no run support, like you said earlier, man.
I mean,
that's what I'm saying. Yeah. You feel like you can't make any mistakes. You're playing for a last place team. I mean, that's a lot of pressure.
Yep. Yeah. And he made the point, too, going against a guy like Gerrit Cole and a team like the Astros. But who's your Seattle most valuable player?
Yeah, I feel like any time you have your all-star, your leader, he goes down in Robinson Cano, and obviously for a very bad reason. But you need guys to step up. You need team guys. And the guy that comes to my mind is D. Gordon. Not only did he move to center field this year to start the season off, but when Robinson Cano went down, he said, you know what, guys, I got this covered, man. I can play second base. And like you're saying, man, I mean, he can play above average defense anywhere you put him in the lineup, man. I love what he brings to the ballpark. He's a veteran. He has so much fun. And you know, man, people love this guy.
Yeah, and for me, as Gene Segura, he's been an absolute great pickup for the Seattle Mariners. Last 15 games, hitting .380, 15 runs, and 24 hits.
Dude.
He's one of the best table setters in all of baseball, and he also plays defense. So I love his effort. He's quiet, but he goes about his business. If they don't have that type of productivity from him, especially in a two-hole spot, they don't have the streak they've been going on right now.
Yeah, and the schedule, they've been taking advantage of teams, we'll just say at the lower portion of their division, but they have a stretch coming up in mid-June where they have 10 games, all with either Red Sox or Yankees. That'll be an early test for them to see just where they are. But right now, to be ahead of the defending World Series champs, that's impressive.
They did good in Houston. They had some fight. They put them on the ropes. They gave a game away, but they like their chances going head-to-head, especially against the playoff contending team. I think they'll be okay.
Yeah, if you would have told me or any of us up here if the Seattle Mariners would be in first place this late in the season, we would have told you were absolutely
crazy. I don't think anybody in their front office would have said something like that.
So
they're happy. They're in a good spot
right now. It
feels
like they're playing with house money right now. Obviously, you love their pitching staff.
Yes.
They're doing a tremendous job. And anytime you have great pitching and you play great defense, you always give yourself a chance to win.
Yeah, it's been 15 years since they've been in first at this point of the season.